not seeing your father for 25 years. The letters that he used to write to me were in a midrashic style. Ata chafetz, instead of ata rotze, ata chafetz, do you want? All kind of words that we are not using. I was very ashamed of him. And he didn't mean to me anything. I went through the war, I was already, I lived with a girlfriend. He meant nothing to me. Hardly one of his books was translated into Hebrew, The Family Muscat. I didn't bother to read it. I rejected it. I took him out of my life. From the age of 5 to the age of 25. What remained? His letters, I still remember he used to, once a year, he sent me $3, and I used to buy a piece of chocolate and divide it into the people in my class. And they used to ask me, when your father again is going to send you money? They thought it was a wonderful idea, because this was an American chocolate that we bought. But before I went to America, my mother wanted to tell me all his nasty things towards her. She said, I don't want to hear. I want to come to him tabula rasa, without anything. I don't want to hear anything. And I remember when an American tourist used to come to the kibbutz, was always fat with a big cigarette, and he used to look around and say, well, what a beautiful place, turn off the car and going away. Said, well, if my father looks like them, no chance. And all the time, and I asked, as I was on the boat, I asked myself, what father means to me? What do we have in common? No love, no sympathy. He writes Yiddish, I don't know any Yiddish. He is probably imperialist. I am socialist. He lives in the exile. I neglect exile. I think all the Jews should come to Israel. He hates Stalin. He thought he was a murderer. I was a Stalinist. What remains between us? How am I going to see America? Because that's what I wanted to see, not him was the last thing that bothered me. I'm telling you the truth, you know.